This is an original French poster from 1955 for the film LOLA MONTES. It was folded and in poor condition, and we gave it a poster fix. Watch.
As you can see, the poster is folded and it has folio folds. We've put wheat paste on the screen here and we're laying the poster down onto the wheat paste. The poster has breaks and rips. And we have Andre Previn playing in the background because he died today. These will get restored later. Most of this paper is there. It'll just go back into place. Interesting how the print goes right down to the bottom. There are no margins, really. That's the way it was printed. We're now saturating it with water to encourage the poster to expand and to absorb the wheat paste. In case you don't know it already, linen backing is a process where we affix your vintage poster to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas, which not only enhances the longevity of the poster, but also its value.
This film, LOLA MONTES, 1955. It's a historical romance film about LOLA MONTES and the last completed film of German-born director Max Ophüls. The movie is based on the life of the celebrated Irish dancer and courtesan LOLA MONTES, who lived from 1821 to 1861. Her full name was Marie Dolores Eliza Rosanna Gilbert, Countess of Lansfeld. She was known better by the stage name LOLA MONTES, and she became famous as a Spanish dancer, courtesan, and mistress of King Ludwig of Bavaria, who made her countess. And she used her influence to institute liberal reforms at the start of the revolutions of 1848 in the German states. She was forced to flee. She proceeded to the United States via Switzerland, France, and London, returning to her work as an entertainer and lecturer. And she is buried in the Greenwood Cemetery in Brooklyn, right near me. She died in 1861 at a very young age of 40 of syphilis. In the movie, she is portrayed by Martine Carroll and tells the story of the most famous of her many notorious affairs, those with Franz Liszt and Ludwig of Bavaria. A French production. The dialogue is mostly in French and German, with a few English language sequences. This movie was the most expensive European film produced up to this time, but this movie flopped at the box office. However, it had an important artistic influence. It influenced the French New Wave. It's respected by many film critics. It has a lot of admirers. It was re-released a few times, heavily edited to try to make it shorter, and it's been restored. It was restored in 1968, and again in 2008, released on DVD and Blu-ray in North America by the Criterion Collection in 2010. Generally speaking, posters printed in the 1950s linen back very well. the paper seems to agree with having wheat paste put on it. It expands evenly. It's sturdy enough that it can be handled wet, and it's a pleasure to work with.
But head shops often would carry, I know what you mean, yeah, I've seen them too. There's certain a certain amount of them they sell in smoke shops like that, that sell cigarettes and pipes and cigars. But head shops particularly focus on opium and pot smoking, counterculture things. So, you know, they'll have 100 different styles of bongs, big bongs from all over the world. There used to be a lot of great head shops in Greenwich Village. Whenever friends of mine would come to New York, we'd go there because they didn't have them in New Hampshire. They would have just tons of bongs, and they'd sell condoms too, you know, and sex toys. It's like the whole thing was kind of a counterculture thing.
Hit thing.
Yeah. I don't know if there are any left in New York to me. Jinbei is cleaning off the poster now with a sponge to get off all the excess wheat paste. Make sure all the paper is in the right place.
You're probably wondering, is a PosterFix compatible with archival standards and practices? Or in other words, is our process of linen backing a process that is accepted as a means of preserving a vintage poster? And the answer is generally yes. Generally, because most collectors, auction houses, museums, and so forth, respect and acknowledge the benefits of linen backing, provided it is archival linen backing.
Very nice job, Jinbei. We're gonna let this poster dry for a few days before we do the restoration. We can just leave it in here, up against there, in that position, facing. No need to put it in the hallway because we're not doing any more work today.
Some areas of archiving old paper ephemera where linen backing may not be chosen as the option for preservation. There are other means to preserve vintage paper. However, those means are not always practical to the everyday collector and displayer of vintage posters. They have to do with encapsulating the poster inside Mylar and giving it a special acid bath and keeping it out of light and keeping it basically out of circulation. Linen backing is a generally good way to make the poster usable, displayable. I'm doing the color retouching using watercolor pencils and watercolor markers. This is an archival way of doing restoration, and it is water reversible. This French poster from 1955 for Lola Montez has been preserved through PosterFix. This is Chris. After 30 years of restoring original vintage posters, I still look forward to linen backing yours. Until the next time, thank you very much.